Right now, there's a revolution going on in the industry. Or is there? Well, many claim that we are now at the start of the fourth industrial revolution. In this lecture, we will take a closer look at the so-called Industry 4.0. Industry 4.0 is a German industrial policy launched at the Hannover Fair in 2011. If it is the fourth, which were the three preceding revolutions? Well, the first industrial revolution, or the industrial revolution, started 250 years ago in the textile industry of Northern England. Engineers at that time figured out how to use water and steam power to mechanize production. This enabled factories to be built and work to be divided into smaller tasks. The second industrial revolution used electric power to create mass production. By allowing energy to be transferred over long distances, there were no more need to locate factories right next to rivers, nor to have dangerous large rotating shafts in the factory buildings. The third industrial revolution happened with the introduction of computers in manufacturing around the 1960s, when work tasks could be automated and machines controlled remotely. Today, we are again witnessing new technology changing how we produce and deliver value. The fourth industrial revolution is best described as a merge of the physical and digital worlds, a form of cyber-physical production system. The technology that really sets it apart is the opportunity to connect processes, products, and people through the internet. The question is this really new? Is it a revolution or an evolution? Consider this quote from a Delphi study from 1971. By 1985, full online automation and optimization of complete manufacturing plants controlled by a central computer will be a reality. I think we can safely say that still in 2020, this is not a reality. Engineers have been working on the same visions for 40 years or more. In the 1980s, the big term was computer-integrated manufacturing. While, of course, there's been great improvements regarding how we use IT in manufacturing, the visions from that have not been realized, and the same visions resurface today under the label Industry 4.0. On the other hand, there are good reasons to believe that this time is indeed different. The World Economic Forum's founder, Professor Klaus Schwab, is convinced that we are at the beginning of a revolution that is fundamentally changing the way we live, work, and relate to each other. In his book, The Fourth Industrial Revolution, he provides three core arguments. First, the velocity by which technology develops is exponential today. Second, the breadth and depth of technologies and their effect on the economy, business, society, individuals are unprecedented. And third, systems are more interwoven than ever before, so a change in one system leads to a change in another system, often with the speed of light. Now, taken together, these three characteristics create a revolution, according to the World Economic Forum. I guess, if there's one technological breakthrough that drives the fourth industrial revolution, it is the internet, with its related innovations such as social media, the Internet of Things, smartphones, artificial intelligence, and the digital platform economy. Note that Industry 4.0 is a flexible term. Many people use it to refer to all kinds of technologies introduced in companies. For example, Internet of Things, including RFID, barcodes, and sensors, virtual reality and augmented reality, mobile computing and wearables, blockchain, drones, automation, additive manufacturing, big data analytics and artificial intelligence, cybersecurity technologies, and digital platforms. It is actually not unusual for firms to refer to an implementation of an ERP system or a manufacturing execution system as Industry 4.0, even if these technologies should, in my view, sort under the third industrial revolution. Perhaps we can note one commonality among the technologies I just mentioned. They are all technologies relying on computers connected with physical processes. Hence, the American term cyber-physical production system is quite accurate. So while we acknowledge that change is coming, as it always have, we should be aware that ever since the 1950s, futurists and engineers have proclaimed a revolution where computers take over manufacturing completely. It hasn't happened to date. Maybe a recent lesson from Tesla can be useful. After many problems with a high-tech factory in California, Tesla decided to remove a lot of the fully automated conveyors and replace them with people. Humans are indeed often underrated.
If you, at this point, think that I'm saying computers can't improve manufacturing, you got it totally wrong. The physical and the digital worlds are merging, and there is an enormous potential in improving manufacturing and services with digital technologies. It just isn't as easy as sometimes one can get the impression of. Technology potential is different from technology usage. So, are we in the fourth industrial revolution, or are we witnessing an evolution? I'll let you decide.